Hello and welcome to this Necron Dynasty Parade Ready painting video. In this video, we're going to be focusing on bringing our battle ready Dynasty models up to a parade ready standard. So that's focusing on layering and highlighting. Now we're going to start with the Sautek Dynasty and work our way through the other ones that were also featured in the battle ready video. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints and let's get started. So we're going to start with the Sautek Dynasty first. I'm going to start with highlighting the armor. So for this, we'll be using Stormhost Silver and a small layer brush. So all I'm going to do is just load up my brush with a couple of dollops of paint, like so, and then a little touch of water. Now the key thing here is to make sure you get a nice point to the brush as well. So when doing any kind of edge highlighting, you always want to have a nice sharp point to it. So just keep spinning it around like so until you get a nice point, and then we're ready to start highlighting. So what I'm going to do is start picking out like the edges and stuff. So things like the shoulder pads here, you can just use the edge of the brush like so and just get a nice consistent line. That's the great thing about things like this. You always get a nice consistent line when you're just using the edge of the brush. However, in some places, you're going to have to use the tip of the brush just to get some of those details. So just take your time, find all those edges and start picking them out. Having your shoulders supported on a nice surface like the table will give you a nice strong line as well. So it won't be so wobbly, you won't get shaky hands as much. There we are with the Necron armor now highlighted. What we're going to do now is move on to highlighting the other details. So we're going to start by highlighting the black details, and for this we'll be using Dawnstone. After that, for the green cables, we'll be using Warpstone Glow to finish off a nice little highlight of Moot Green. And then for any of the glow effects, we're going to finish off by just doing a couple of dots of white scar. But first of all, let's move on to the black. So as always, I'm just going to get a couple of dollops onto my palette, a little touch of water, and then the key thing of making sure I just roll that brush so I can get a nice point to those bristles. And then we're ready to start highlighting black casing. So again, if you're not sure where the highlights will go, it's always worth just checking the box art to see where Heavy Metal have highlighted theirs as a good point of reference. But most of the time, you're just looking to pick out the edges. With the black gun casings now highlighted, we're going to move on to highlighting the gun cables. And now for this, we'll be using Warpstone Glow as the first colour. So I'm starting about the middle here, just to give it a bit of a, like a transition, like an energy glow. Now you can always like add a bit more water to your mix and then just make it a little bit lighter as it gets closer to the edges like so. And again, there's other cables probably underneath where it's rib cages, so just make sure you do those as well. There we are, with the Warpstone Glow now applied. What we're going to do is move on to Moot Green, and we're just going to do a little fine highlight just going across the cable like so. So take your time. If you do find it gets a bit wibbly wobbly, just use your Warpstone Glow to make it a little bit finer again. There we are, now that we've highlighted that cable in Moot Green, we're going to finish off by using White Scar to pick out the glowy area. So I'm just going to do a little dot here and there on those orbs. Also, if you wanted to, just to make some more definition, a bit more of a glow effect on your cable, you can always add a couple of little dots of white on here as well, like so, give it more of a glowy effect. And of course, don't forget the eyes. And there we are with the Sautek Dynasty done. We're now going to move on to our next one, which is the Nylak Dynasty. So as you can see here, I've already brought us some bits to parade ready level following the Sautek guide. So again, that's the armor, the cables, the gun, etc. So what we're going to concentrate on now is the turquoise armor and the gold. So first of all, we're going to start with the gold. We'll be using Retributor Armor as a tidy. So that's just picking out some of the raised details. We'll then highlight with Stormhost Silver. After that, for the turquoise, we'll use Thousand Suns Blue again, more of a highlight as opposed to a layer. And then we'll finish off with Aramin Blue as the final highlight. So first of all, let's start off with that Retributor armor. So I'm just going to get a little bit onto the palette, a little touch of water. Again, I'm using a small layer brush for this as well. Again, make sure we get that brush to a nice fine point, like so. And then we'll start picking out those raised areas. So what we're going to do here is just start using Retributor armor just on those raised areas like so, and still maintaining some of those parts with Aggro Silver Shade in the recesses. There we are, with the tidy up of Retributor armor now done, we're going to move on to Stormhost Silver. So we're just going to be concentrating on those edges, sort of like around the eye sockets, his mouth, and obviously the cartouche just down here too. There we are, with the gold now done, we're going to move over to the turquoise. And for this, we'll be starting off with Thousand Suns Blue. Instead of a layer, I'm going to start doing this as a chunky edge highlight, because the great thing about using something like a Thousand Suns Blue than doing a shade is you'll get another tone if you just use it as a highlight straight after. You can see here, you've almost got a different colour. So I'm going to do this first of all, I'm just going to start going around all those edges. Don't forget the cartouche and the stripe on his helmet as well. There we are, with the Thousand Suns Blue now applied, we're going to finish off by using Aramin Blue. So again, just going to be using the edge of the brush like so, just get a nice fine line. Now the idea is to get a line slightly thinner than the previous one so you can have a bit more of a gradient coming through. Take your time. If you make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up with Thousand Suns Bloom. There we are with the Nilak Dynasty now painted up to parade ready level. We're going to move on to the next one, which is the Novak Dynasty. Now, some of the areas have already been painted following the Saltec guide, like the armor, the cables, and the gun. So all we're going to do is concentrate on the red armor and the little white symbol. So first of all, for the red armor, we'll be using Evil Sun Scarlet as the first highlight, followed with Wild Rider Red. And then we're just going to tidy up that symbol with a little bit of Korax White. So first of all, let's start with the red. So I'm just going to apply a little bit of Evil Sun Scarlet, a little touch of water again. And again, the key thing here, keep making sure you get that brush to a nice point. So roll it around like so. And then we're ready to start doing our highlighting. So I'm just going to, like we did on the Nilak Dynasty one, is start running it around the edges like so. Again, this first highlight can be quite chunky, because the next one will add a bit more definition as well. There we are, with the Evil Sun Scarlet now done, we're going to move on to using Wild Rider Red. So again, we're just going to make sure this is a light, slightly finer highlight, just so we can see some of that Evil Sun Scarlet through. So just take your time to work your way around the model like so. Again, if you make any mistakes, you can just tidy back up with the previous colours. There we are, with that final highlight done on the red. What we're going to do now is just use a bit of Korax White to tidy up that sigil on his ankh. Again, it's just using Korax White again as a tidy, just to make it have a little bit more emphasis. Because in some places, especially when you're doing this, the shades will darken it down ever so slightly. And you can see I'm just using the edge of the brush and just going over, because it is a raised detail. It's just easy to do that way, like so. There we are with the Novak Dynasty now done. We're going to move on to the next one, which is the Mefrit Dynasty. Now, the majority of this model has been painted following the Saltec guide. So what we're going to concentrate on now is the armor, which is going to be green, and of course the orange glow. So for the green armor, we're going to tidy back up with Deathwood Forest, and then we'll be using Zamissi Desert as a final highlight on it. And after that, we're just going to use Fire Dragon Bright to really make that orange glow pop out. So first of all, let's start with that Deathwood Forest. So we're going to treat it as a bit of a highlight. So all I want to do is add a little bit of water to that. I'm still using my small layer brush. And again, the key thing here is get a nice point to the brush. We'll move that little thing out there. We don't need that. There we are. Once I've got a nice point to it, we're ready to start highlighting up. So again, just using the edge of your brush, just work around just to help give you some nice, consistent lines. In some places, you can just use the tip of the brush as well. There we are with that tidy up now done. We're going to move on to Zamissi Desert. So this is going to be a nice fine highlight. So I'm going to start probably on the actual shoulder pads again. So again, using the edge of the brush just to get a nice super fine highlight like so. Just work all the way around. That yellow really helps that green pop out. So just keep working around it and then do the face after. There we are with those Zamissi Desert highlights done. We're going to move on to our final colour, which is Fire Dragon Bright. So all I'm going to be doing here is just picking out on those energy glows with just like a little spot highlight here and there. So do the eyes, these glowing orbs, you've got the little symbol on the ankh, and of course you've got this little bit of energy here. So what I'm just going to do is just do a little line, getting a little bit thicker in the middle here, then thinning back out again. And there we are with the energy glow done. The Mefrit Dynasty is completed. So what I'm going to do now is move on to our next one, which is the Thokt Dynasty. Now I'm going to start with the black armor. This will use Dark Reaper as the first highlight, then we'll move to Fenris in Grey after. Then for the bone plates, or the ceramic armor if you like, we'll be using Rakar Flesh as a tidy, then finish off with a final highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh. Then just to make the energy pop on the actual Gauze Flayer, we'll use a little bit of White Scar for that. But first of all, let's start with the Dark Reaper. So I'm just going to get a couple of dollops on my palette, a little bit of water, and again, as always, try and get a nice point to this brush. And then the next thing we're going to do is make sure we do some nice chunky highlights here. So with doing any kind of like dark highlights like this, you probably want the first one to be quite thick. So I'm just going to do that. If you make it like a bit wibbly wobbly, don't worry. You can always use a little bit of a Bad and Black to tidy up. So just take your time and go around all the armor plates with Dark Reaper. There we are with the Dark Reaper now applied. We're going to move on to using Fenris in Grey as our final highlight. So I'm just going to start on the shoulder panels here. And again, I'm just going to do this one a little bit thinner so you can see some of that Dark Reaper showing through as well. Again, take your time. If you make any mistakes, just tidy back up those previous colours. There we are with the black armour now done. We're going to move on to painting the bone slash ceramic panels. Now for this, we'll be using Rakar Flesh as our first layer stroke highlight. So we're just going to be doing that to tidy up the raised areas while still maintaining that Agraxur shade in the recesses. There we are with that tidy stage done. We're now going to move on to a highlight, and for this we'll use Pallid Witch Flesh. There we are with the bone and ceramic bits now done. We're just going to finish off by making that glow pop out a little bit more by doing a little bit of white scar on just the tips of the glow, like so. Don't forget to do the eyes, and you can also just pick out these little energy bits on the gun as well. There we are with that highlight done. The Thok dynasty is completed. So what we're going to do now is move on to our final dynasty, which is the Ogdebek dynasty. Now we're going to start by doing the brass armor. For this, we'll tidy back up with Screaming Bell, and then we'll move to a highlight of Fulgurite Copper. After that, we'll then use Strachan Green as our first highlight, followed by Elysian Green. And then we'll finish off by just highlighting any other little silver details with Stormhost Silver. First of all, let's start with the Screaming Bell tidy. So I'm just going to get a little bit out of the pot. Just apply a little bit like so, a little bit more. Move that around so it's mixed in a bit better. Now, obviously the key bit here is just make sure we get a nice point to the brush. And all I'm going to do is on some of those raised areas is start actually just highlighting up or layering up some of that copper again. Again, still keeping that Agrax Earth shade in the recesses. There we are with the Screaming Bell now tidied up. We're going to move on to Fulgurite Copper. So this is going to be our edge highlight on this nice brass armor or copper armor, if you like. I'm just going to do some fine highlights on things like the raised areas, the knuckles, etc. So take your time. If you do make any mistakes or you get some wibbly wobbly highlights, just use Screaming Bell to tidy back up. There we are, the copper armor done. We're now going to move on to the green panels. Now for this, we're going to start with Strachan Green. So I'm just going to do an edge highlight like so. Just work the way all the way around. And again, if you make any mistakes, you can tidy back up with Caliban. Make sure you put that shade back over. There we are with the Strachan Green highlight now done. We're going to move on to Elysian Green, and all I'm going to be doing here is just picking out those edges just slightly finer than the previous highlight. There we are with the green armor now highlighted. We're going to move on to the final highlight, which is Stormhost Silver. So this is going to be used on the face and also some of the joints as well. And there we are with the silver highlights now done. Our Ogdebek dynasty is completed. And you'll also notice that I've finished off the gauze fillet, and that is just following the Saltec guide. And with that, our parade-ready dynasty video is now done. Now remember, you can easily transfer these colour schemes to other models in your collection as well. Now, there's one important thing to remember when doing edge highlighting is always try and keep your hand as steady as you can, whether that's holding your breath for a short period of time and also stabilising your arms just to get a nice steady hand. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Necron dynasties, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.